Well now, welcome everybody to another exciting episode of Gay Guy the Worm and the Crab. Yeah, that's right. Michael B., this is what you get when you don't fucking show up exactly when the show starts. Yay. Good morning. Whoa. How you doing?
I'm Peachy.
Hi, Peachy. I'm Banana. Whoa, we're wacky and crazy today. You know, I'm actually sad that I've not been getting to listen to free beer and hot wings. My radio just won't pick it up. I don't get it. It's like it's a phantom station now.
Do you want me to put it on for you? I get it.
Yes.
Okay.
This guy gets it, everybody.
Listen to free beer and hot wings for the rest of the day.
Turn on my clock radio here.
All right. Turn that knob and set it to your favorite station. The station that pays.
Turn on your radio dial.
Turn your dial to WNICBOIS. That's right. The Nice Boys Show.
That's not where I thought you were going with that one.
I heard NI and I thought something else.
Yep.
Your radio has better taste than I do. Clearly, Michael. Clearly. We can see that. Should I be worried about Lou? Like having another passive-aggressive, bizarre Toby situation? I mean, he's not showing up on time with his titties all out. I sat on my bed last night in just my underpants.
Just playing with your tits?
I was like, what am I doing with myself? What have I done? What? I feel like, I don't know. You could do a year of work, and like a month, you could just fuck that work right up. I become a big fat jello boy.
I feel personally attacked.
This is what happened since you lost your job. You got real fat. Is that what you're trying to say?
No, but the beard does make my face look round.
Oh my god, dude. Look, I feel so fat.
Fat, you guys?
And my big fat fucking gut is killing me.
Do I look fat in this mask?
With a pH.
He looks fat, everybody. Let's go back to that. It was so much better than this self-depreciating nonsense. I want to kill myself. What are you doing? Wait, what is that alarm sound? Uh-oh. Don't ask Mr. A-Crab about an alarm. Never mind.
What's that alarm?
Oh, okay. It's a different alarm.
Mm-hmm. It's not one that'll get you hung up on by Anthony Kumian.
You've even been hung up on by Anthony Kumian. You know, you guys were going to see my Anthony Kumian. It was going to be really bad. I almost wish that you guys didn't show up. 2 minutes late, Damien!
I lost track of time.
I'm so disappointed in you. Damien, etou.
I didn't get to finish my movie.
Beavis and Butthead do the universe?
Yeah, I got like 15 minutes left.
What are you up to? I wasn't saying anything important a second ago. It makes sense to change topics. There was no topic, right? I was just babbling, right?
Yeah, like most days.
Pretty sure it's all I'm doing. That's why I don't remember. Like, sometimes Derek will message me afterwards and he'll be like, He'll say something in reference, or like I said, V will put a comment in reference in the YouTube. I have no idea. I have no idea what these people are talking about.
Remember that thing you said?
No.
No, I don't. It was 2 minutes ago. Yeah, and your point is.
Yeah.
But I'm up to the escape scene when they when they were handcuffed. They try to re-handcuff themselves.
I don't recall this. Captured
towards the end. Yeah,
he's trying to make us not score. Well, Mr. A-Crab has seen the, you know, we're gonna go, we're gonna respect each other's monikers and pronouns from henceforth. So, you know, I will refer to you as Mr. A-Crab.
I'm not a crab.
I will refer to you as whatever is on your screen, and I expect the same courtesy. It's only decent.
Okay, Mr. Fancy Penis.
Thank you. Thank you. He said, "I have a fancy hat penis,
like Edda Beasy from Oz." You know that little hat he had.
Now, that is racist. That is absolutely racist. That is a cultural appropriation done by my penis.
Well, that's on you, not me.
If I fuck a black girl, is that cultural appropriation?
Mm-mm. It's
what
rape.
About my penis is wearing the Ababa D baby BB?
It might be. I don't know what the rules are anymore.
Anyway, we were to oh. So, Mr. A-Crab, you have seen the show, the series now, without spoiling anything. How great was, well, number one, how great was the escape room? I thought that was brilliant.
Yeah, that was great. That
as was soon as they went that direction, I was like, yep.
Yeah, it's what they were supposed to do.
Yeah. That was
how many are out now? Like 3, 2?
Well, how do you quantify your Beavis and Butthead? By an episode which contains 2 segments and multiple videos, or do you call them? Because if you go to the streaming sites, like, well, I won't say the name of it, but you know, the illegal streaming sites, they'll say there's 4 episodes, but they're just giving you the 10-minute segments. So there's 2 episodes with 2 segments in each.
So it's sort of like Nickelodeon shows used to do in the 90s, where it's like 2 episodes in one.
Like, or it's exactly like minutes. Beavis and Butthead would do, Damien. Fuck is wrong,
I don't remember.
With you, man?
do you want a list?
It's fucking ridiculous. I got to wake up in the morning to fucking deal with this.
Yes.
Are you making the videos?
I am. You ain't never gonna eat chicken in this house again. If you don't give me back my cracker box, you better give me back my cracker box. It's just some funny shit. Or the ASMR, the payoff.
Oh, yeah.
I mentioned this, I think, on the show. Again, I won't spoil it. I hate ASMR. Even Beavis and Butthead doing it kind of hurt. Not really, though. But the payoff is almost like 30 years in the making. Seriously, yeah. It's a punchline 30 years in the making. Haha, it's a punchline almost 30 years in the making. It's very, very, very funny, I think. In my opinion, I look forward to hearing what you have to say. But Mr. A-Crab, have you seen Better Call Saul? Do you watch that?
Oh, no. I've been meaning to. I started watching it, and for some reason I was like, I don't know if I can get into this, and I stopped watching it.
It starts slow. It started very slow.
It's ending fucking slow, too. That's what I don't want to, like, spoil. It's a fantastic show. I fully recommend it. I was one of those people who took a long time to get into Breaking Bad. I no fucking way. I don't want to watch fucking Malcolm in the Middle's dad in his underpants running around again. I had enough of that for the last 8 years with Malcolm in the Middle. Why does this guy have to keep being in his underwear? What was he so obsessed with it? Like... Just some fucking old guy in tighty whities.
His body is more flabby and pasty now, but he's still in his undies.
Yeah, and he's sweeping the nation in those undies. Don't understand it. But I refused, finally, gave in, and I'm so glad. Some of the greatest television ever made. But this ending is definitely as slow as the beginning. I didn't think the beginning was slow, personally. I thought it was good. The ending, however... We'll address you in a minute, Michael B. You just sit fucking tight. We're talking about something else. Jesus Christ.
Men are talking.
Men are talking, Michael. Get back in your boy corner. God damn it, Michael. You see, you just totally just made me... It's going slow. The ending of Better Call Saul is very slow. I'm
Until
almost
this last
pissed
episode,
off.
Really?
I'm almost pissed off. Like, you think the last episode was... I thought this was the slowest one of the season.
It really sets up what's going to happen.
Sure.
I don't know exactly what that is, but...
Right. But it's all depending on what that is. If that is garbage, then this was garbage.
was garbage.
It's almost meandering. But anyway, Michael's and, more important. Go ahead. You have something to say?
I was going to say, one thing I did notice is, I don't, was Jesse Pinkman always such a caricature of a human being?
Man, no.
Am I just like...
No.
Because in this most recent episode, he seemed like... It's like if you stuck fucking Jason Mewes in there, and he was just saying snoochy broochies. Like, well, that's what thing. It felt like to me. Like, you put,
he had
you
character put... development. He was, Leo, that he was snoochy boochy in the beginning, but then after a few seasons, after, you know, people died around him and he started getting cold and callous, he, you know, I don't think he was, hey, guys, having... let's put some chili pea in it.
I've got feelings, yo.
Yeah, bitch! My girl died, bitch!
It's a rare thing that you find comments in a YouTube video or something that are, you know, insightful or good, but somebody made a good point about Pinkman in these Better Call Saul episodes is that, like you just said, there was an emotional arc to the character, there was development, and it also happened in his vocal range. It began at a certain register, and as it went on, it wasn't just the aging. It was, you know, an actor's choice. It got more gruff. It got a different delivery, etc. And they're saying, they made the point that in these flashback scenes, he wasn't playing the proper Jesse Pinkman. He was playing more of an El Camino version of Jesse Pinkman. And they are correct.
So that's pretty much him throughout that movie. It's just more like...
You've never seen that still?
No, not yet.
Well, chimney crickets. Look who decides to show up! Oh! What a piece of shit. Hey, how you doing? Morning. How are you? Get that finger out of my... Okay, you're jerking it, then that's fine. As long as you jerk it after and during and before, rub it.
God, man.
Take your pants off and jacket.
So Michael B. asks, where's Beavis and Butthead airing? Paramount Plus. And as well, is it on Comedy Central yet? Well, what would you know? You live in Australia like an idiot.
I don't know anything.
Like a fucking dork. Only
Paramount Plus seems to be grabbing up every goddamn thing.
Well, good for them. Good for them. I think they're poised to win, to be honest with you. They just they seem to be picking up the right content. They seem to be investing correctly. Again, you're bringing back Beavis and Butthead, throwing us a movie after all these years, and then boom, straight into the series. Smart fucking move. They're going dick deep with Star Trek. Like, every fucking thing that they're putting their money into, they're going all in on. Unlike Amazon, who's fucking, you know, how many shows have they started and quit before they even aired? Like,
I was gonna say, they canceled the good shit.
Yeah, they cancel good shit before it gets anywhere, or they even, like Gunslinger, fucking the Dark Tower series, rather. They fucking canceled that shit before it aired, and that looked good, actually. The whole pilot was done, but anywho's. That's the answer to that, Michael. Oh, I feel emotionally abused. Why don't you cry about it passive-aggressively for fucking 9 months and actually never say a word at all, and then one day just completely make a wheeze? You know, I gotta say, I didn't give a shit at first. Because, like, there was no hard feelings, but... or malice or anything. I never had negative feelings up until that moment. And even in that moment, you didn't, because how can you really be affected by the absence of a non-entity? You know what I'm saying? Like, something that really... we might have thought it was something. Like we might have thought Toby was here doing something. But he really wasn't. And it didn't really bother me at all. And the fact
that... I think I lost count of the amount of times you called him a terrible producer.
Obsessed. Because he wasn't one. He never was one. Obsessed. It was all a joke. It was all a joke. I was doing the buttons. He was hardly doing buttons. And when he did, they sucked. With his fucking... Anyway.
He's obsessed with me.
But...
obsessed!
But I really... Because I got all the content... I didn't even care. They didn't, yeah, oh, we lost a couple videos with a couple hundred views on them. Oh, wow. You know, whoopity-doo. Sucks, I guess. But really didn't care. But as the days are going by, I keep thinking, wow. It's growing to where I'm starting to very much dislike Toby. Like, I'm starting to finally see it, and it's like, what a little cocksucker. Like, what a gross, just what a fucking fag. I'm sorry for the word. I'm sorry, homosexuals, Steve. I don't even want to call, because, well, fag doesn't mean homosexual. You people got to stop stealing all the words, okay? Fuck off.
You can be straight as an arrow and still be a faggot.
Right. What am I supposed to call this fucking cunt? Like, if I don't have that word, what am I supposed to call him? Give me a word, somebody.
Snoochie Boochie.
Just what a little baby girl. Like, to never, ever give any sign. How many times to you guys who have been at the after shows, it's like, hey, Toby, you doing good? You getting all your shit in? You feeling caught up with the big boys? It's just
did you ever did that? Oh, my God.
And I hate to say it. Well, not in those words, but that's what it was like. I was going to say,
I don't recall that once.
Coddling. And it's just, I don't know.
Yesterday. But I guess his Twitter is gone or something.
And I don't like a thing about your glasses.
All I'm saying is what he did is far more shitty. Like, we should be railing about it like Gino's railing about Pat Dixon. And yet, there's no reason to, because this is what you get. Oh, this is so much more boring.
But I hate your faggy ass, too.
Keep singing. Keep singing. Ooh. And I'm not being sarcastic. Please keep singing through this. You've got to save this. That's the only thing that was working. I'm just trying to say and be honest with you guys that I'm realizing now that I'm suddenly very, I just think he's a giant jerk-off queer suddenly. Like, I really didn't care up until maybe the day before yesterday where just these things start rolling in my head like, wow, what a fucking queer jerk-off. What a fucking nerd. Don't you talk
bullshit.
Oh, we can call him a tranny because the LGBTs, they're booting the trannies. Did you know this? They said no more T's. They said the T's are misogynistic. They say they are homophobic. That they
I hate the alphabet, hate the too.
It's like, they said no the T's shit. The F's. Anyone with half a brain has seen that since this shit started.
Well, it's like because a lot of those T's, they kind of talk like us. And look, say us because despite the varied ideologies, I think we all share the common ground of, like, who gives a fuckism and fuck you-ism and suck a dickism. You know, like, eat a dick and
yeah,
like it.
Do what you want. Suck a dick. I don't care. Just leave me out of it.
Yeah. And most trannies are kind of that same mindset. You know what I'm saying? Like,
and eat my dick before I lose it.
The gay narrative. They're not fitting with the gay narrative of do what we say, be how we be. Can give me a string of words that don't make sense, because that's how you can give their idea.
Cat, yeah, 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 we're all queer and gay.
Dog. That's the gay mantra.
That's the phrase that pays.
The phrase that pays on Mr. Fancy Penis and Damian J. Rogers.
The phrase that gays.
Unemployed Australian.
That's the phrase that gays.
Phrase that gays, that's a good one.
The gays that pay.
No, see, that's too much on the nose. Gays always pay.
I'm pay for gay.
I think we need to just cancel Michael B. I think I already addressed this. Says El Camino is fabulous. No, it's not. It's fucking
really.
That's the first time I've heard that. I haven't seen it. Everyone else told me just like, don't bother. It was pointless. El Camino is hearing.
Because I think people want this now. I think most people want nostalgia with El Camino, and I think, like, are you really expecting nostalgia with that?
No,
or
I don't want nostalgia. I
don't. My sister's name is Nostalgia.
No, I want fucking a better
conclusion. The fiber of nostalgia.
Look, you can boil that movie down to Jesse Pinkman got in his car after that Walter White event and drove away. That's what the movie boils down to, really. Like, a thing happens along the way. A thing. Maybe two.
It's like, what's the basic premise? Like, they pick him up? Is that it? Like, he gets, like...
No, he doesn't. Gets in his car and he drives away and a thing or two happen along the way to Alaska. Yeah. And the last scene is his car just... It's literally... It's called El Camino. I'm not even joking. He gets in his car and drives away and fucking... Then he leaves the car on the side of a road and that's the end of the movie.
It's just an hour and a half of him singing along to the radio. Yeah. Crying a bit.
Carry on.
When he drives like this.
Bitch. Bitch. Oh, I hate science. My coffee went off. Damien, you said you liked Game of Thrones Season 8. You're a fucking piece of shit. You're worse than a Toby. Why don't you just go ahead and take your cock out so that we lose our channel? I'm going to make a cup of coffee. Explain how Season 8 is acceptable, on par with the rest of the show. By itself, oh, it's
fine. I didn't say it was on par with the rest.
Then it's not good. Then it's a complete abomination. I just said
I didn't hate it.
Just tell me why. I'm just trying to make a coffee.
Well, I didn't hate it because I didn't hate it. I kind of enjoyed it.
Yeah, leave it to the king turd to call to make everybody... His pieces of shit court, huh? Crazy. But go ahead. I'm sorry to interrupt your... was that it? You just didn't hate it?
Yeah, basically. There was a lot of enjoyable shit in there, but... I don't know. I think there was a bit of a decline in the
series.
All
right, great. I'm so glad. I'm back now. We don't need to hear anymore.
My name is Peter, but you can call me Little Wiener.
Damien, steal my line.
Well, look, I really didn't want to talk about Game of Thrones. I really did just want to make a coffee, but speaking of Littlefinger, you know, he who's no longer here. I don't mean Lou. He'll be here in a minute. I mean Toby with the tiny penis. Speaking of Littlefinger, that's one of my disappointments is how they ended with him. I really think he should have won because... He was sort of just... He wasn't even doing it for the money. He was just doing it just to do it. Just because fuck you. And I liked his reason the most out of everybody. Just fuck you. Just because I can. Just because, you know, I just want to stick it to this bitch. I want to just... I just want to. I just want it. And I'm going to get it.
So you've seen Oz, right?
Yep.
I thought he was the Ryan O'Reilly of Game of Thrones.
He managed to
just worm his way through that entire show.
I seen Oz when it was new, so Dream On was still on the air.
I think when that finished, like 2003, I think.
What, really?
I tried watching Oz, but there wasn't enough cock, so I turned it off.
At least in reruns, Stone Age.
How much do you need, Mr. Acre?
I was about to be like, what the hell's going on my timeline? How the fuck does Oz and Dream On overlap?
If they weren't new, let me Google, because fucking, I'm telling you, they may have been on new episodes at the same time, but I do know, I remember that old HBO coming up later on, Gay Guy. Listen, don't make me, Michael, don't make me. I remember those things. After this episode of Dream On, watch these men fuck on Oz. Okay. And then after Oz, another episode of Dream On where Martin Tupper sucks some ladies' toes. There was a lot of that on that show.
Sidebar on Oz real quick. I mean, how many people think that...
97.
Oh, really? Wow. How many people think that a live demo, you know what I'm saying, like jail rape, would have really been an effective scare straight program?
You want
to
rape kids?
So, like, yeah, you're saying send kids to prison to get raped?
No, send them to watch one little prison punk get raped by You know what I'm saying? By his bigger, more brooding fucking
Can we do one episode without a kid getting raped? Oh, my Lord.
Apparently not.
See, that's what...
watching sex.
He suggested 96. 96, Dream On ended. Oz began in 97. Yeah, so there wasn't quite... it was definitely reruns of Dream On.
I can't believe it was... I still can't believe it was that close, though. I still can't believe it was that close.
Show was...
And fucking Edie Falco was in Oz before The Sopranos.
Damn.
Not for very long. I think she left in like season two. I did watch Nurse Jackie.
Shut up, Richard. You sound stupid.
Wait, isn't the guy that comes on Anthony's show on that? What's that fucking guy? Oh, shit. The guy with the mole? The fuck? The guy, oh, God damn
with the mole.
Adam. Is it Adam? Corolla? Not Adam.
Adam Ferrara?
Ferrara, yeah.
I wonder if he drives a Ferrari or something.
They're talking about, it's like me, oh, Adam with another car name.
Adam, fucking... Adam Toyota, he's a goop.
Adam Suzuki, he's part Japanese.
Suzuki.
You know, every Asian I've ever known would make the funniest racist jokes about Asians and their tiny penises. And one of my best friends in high school was named Yellow. That's what he called himself. You know, they've got quite a humor. They go for a good old gook joke because it's a silly fucking word. You know, it's like it's just so funny sounding. Gook.
Like, and spook. Is like spook.
Oh, spook is the funniest. That is so funny.
Especially
really
since
is.
It's so outdated now. It's just like,
yeah, it comes like, what do you imagine when you hear the word spook? I'll tell you what I imagine: a black and white, a black person in a black and white film with their eyeballs bugging out. That's what I picture when I hear the word. When I hear that word.
I always just envisioned a ghost, like, you know what I'm saying? Like a spook, a specter, a spirit. I just always...
Well, they do make that sound in my head. That picture I just painted for you, it does go, woo!
I do believe in spooks. I do believe in spooks.
That's from a movie.
I think, when I hear that word, I think of a German spy.
When I think of Germans, I think of pooping.
When I think of Germans, I think about weird experiments.
I thought that was another word for a German spy, a spook.
All right, hold up though. I see what I see. He sees a ghost. A ghost. What do you guys see? What do you boys see?
I think of a word. Do you remember in South Park when they banned the internet or whatever it was?
No.
And Randy fucking busted in. He was using the internet. Just came all over the room. Oh, it was a spooky ghost. It's ectoplasm.
Let me rephrase the fucking question then, because you guys aren't getting it. Obviously, when someone's talking about a ghost, I don't think of a black person when they say the word spook. I'm speaking specifically
in the black people
the
can
racial...
be ghosts too.
In of course, no. Of course.
Spooks are white.
I don't mean to take it out of way. Black people can die. No.
Go ahead and isolate that.
Not how that sounded. That is not what that was supposed to be. Out of context.
Did you say right now?
Jesus Christ. Sharp turns.
If you say a spook in a normal context, I see skeletons. Spooky, scary skeletons. Or I'll see a ghost in a sheet. But I'm speaking specifically in racial terms when somebody says spook racially.
What do you see?
And that's what I see. So let's
it went
try
over
this
my
again.
Like perfect example when Damien said it. I sat there completely emotionless to it until I heard everybody else's reaction, and then I realized, oh, okay, that was supposed to be about black people. Wow. Like, it kind of just, it didn't register. So, like, that's kind of what, I don't really see anything when thought about it in a racial term, because it just, it was beyond me. You know what I'm saying? It was before me, so I just...
Because it's something well, I don't like think people said, have said since, like, the 60s.
Right. I also don't... It does go past me as a racial term. However, once it is addressed as a racial term, then that is my imagery, and that was sort of... Boy, I guess I'm... So anyway, Michael B. says Adam was on Nurse Jackie.
Yeah, Adam, he was her boyfriend, I think, for...
Adam Mitsubishi.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
For a while, a couple seasons at least, I think.
Adam Pontiac. You know what his last name stands for? Sorry.
What does it stand for?
I don't know. Never mind.
Well, Pontiac, I'm going to assume it's a Native American type thing.
Yeah.
Ah, before Lou gets here and complains about Mary Sue. Poor old
Native. Thinks it's a Cadillac.
I think he was fine with Mary Sue.
Why did you say? So you had that. I know.
It was magical Negroes he was upset about.
Yeah, I know, I know. But that wasn't even the point. The point was people are bringing up Mary Sue in context with or in reference to Prey, saying that that girl's another Mary Sue and this and that. And
I thought yesterday, a Mary Sue, like a magical black person, was supposed to help the situation and like not be the. But she's like the main character. She's helping herself.
See, it's a new thing that they're doing now. But see, Mary Sue was always the last girl. You know what I'm saying? No. And you don't think that's the same thing?
No, a Mary Sue is literally the same thing as the magical Negro is a character who has powers beyond their means that will save the day.
Or at least survive. I mean, that wasn't the last girl.
But it could be. But it's like not all squibs are squabs. You know what I'm saying? Even though all squabs might be squibs, you know, it's a little. For instance, whatchamacallit? The girl in Prey is a final girl, but she's not a Mary Sue. Because they show right away that girl's like a ninja, which is also something that was a little silly we missed. They basically painted Native Americans as fucking lackadaisical fucking
English-accented
ninjas. You know, they
can't
were
two steps away from saying
science bitch.
Look at all these teepee we have because we are Indians.
And they had trappers, too. You know, we're talking about Cannibal the Musical.
You don't even know what it means to be a trapper. I can catch a helpless animal, skin it with my bare hands. I wake up muddy, I go to bed bloody, because I'm a trapping man. Yo.
You know,
I'm better than a batter sailor. Make love to women 10 feet tall. All right.
No, please keep going.
I got a chest of wonder and balls of thunder. I can break right through a wall.
From Virginia to Australia, we're just being weirded out right here.
See, you guys, obviously, you know, I never like to brag or like bring up any. I never do any of that stuff. But I got to tell
you,
I was one of the first people on the planet to see that movie years before it hit any sort of market or anything due to my time at Troma Films, where I used to work.
That is another one with a great, what is it, when they talk over the movie at the end? The commentary? Yeah. Trey and Matt do the fucking commentary on it. And my favorite part is when he brings up the scene where his keys jingle. You can hear my keys jingle at the end here, right here. And here's me saying, cut.
I've never heard that. I would actually love to hear that, because South Park, for the few episodes they did like 7 minutes of commentary at best for each episode.
Have you ever seen Cannibal the Musical?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I think I know exactly what I mean when I say it's a Spadoinkle day.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
They play Cannibal that song the at the end of every South Park episode. At the end of the episode, the you cue. See playing it goes. Din, 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 din. That's Spadoinkle.
Sky day. Is blue and all the leaves are green. My heart's as full as a baked potato. I don't know why potatoes always stuck with me.
Stone, look at this. We just got to keep him. Hold on. Wait, hold on. Don't let that face go away. When I say it's Ashpadoinkle Day.
When I say it's Ashpadoinkle
Day. You know, that's like Soul to Squeeze. What does he say? Do 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 dang a dang a dong dong a ding a dong a ding a dong a dong dong ding. Like enough forget, but that wait. I don't know what he says there, but that part of Spadoinkle to me is much like that Soul to Squeeze. Much like Squeeze.
I've been wanting to give that a rewatch for years. Fucking love that movie.
We're just gonna do all the songs right now. Would you? You want to? Build a snowman?
Well, let's build a snowman. We can make him our best friend. The only thing I remember is we can name him Beowulf. That's the only thing.
Make him Bob, or we can name him Beowulf. How did he do that tap dancing? That's all I want to know.
I think Orgasmo only had, I think the only song in that was Now You're a Man, right? Which is one of the greatest songs ever written.
Yeah, I don't. That wasn't a musical.
No. Although there was the other one where I don't remember what they said exactly, but it's like, now the radio is singing to you.
That was basketball.
In your car in the rain. Oh, that's basketball, isn't it?
You got what's in your dick that won't go away. Use topical ointment every day.
Fucking Dale Earnhardt, then.
Topical ointment. That's from something else they did. What? I can't remember. Is that from Orgasmo originally? There's a running topical ointment joke somewhere before that song.
You're gonna make me kill, or I'm gonna kick your butt.
Stuntcock. Stuntcock.
Stuntcock. We just keep talking about
that. We're purely just entertaining ourselves at this point.
You can't not do all the lines from that movie. There's no way he can bring it up.
I don't want to sound queer or nothing, but I think unicorns kick ass.
I don't want to sound queer or nothing, but I want to put your butthole in my mouth.
You didn't say that one. Oh. I kind of like to make love to you tonight.
And then I want to bend you down over a table, and I want to put two fingers in your butt slow, and then when I'm done, I want to put my wiener in it.
Lou, the dream is real for you. Here it goes.
Two fingers in the butt.
Welcome, Lou. That's your payment. That's your penance for being 40 minutes late. How fucking dare you?
I'm unemployed. I get to sleep in.
Oh, great. We're going to have another 4-hour show of just...
Oh, my.
You nice poor butt. Thing. Look at Lou's butt, everyone. I saw it. I thought you guys did a fine show yesterday. I listened to some in the shower. I was touching myself. And then the car.
God, Damien sounds good.
Oh, that's right. I was messaged by a viewer about a big issue from yesterday's show. My reception cut out. I went to Dead Zone right after you guys were fumbling over
Four Lonely.
Like the whole group here. Stone, I don't know if you were here or not. I don't know if you're included in this.
Bring me in, and I'm going to switch my computers.
Oh, there he is. The whole group was struggling over the word forlorn. And
I think I said it correctly.
No, you said for lonely, apparently. I don't know. It cut out. I don't know where it resolved. All I know is I've got a slew of emails about how retarded you guys all are for that.
Oh, a bunch of emails.
I got 3 emails about it. 3 messages about it.
Only 3?
From the same person?
I got 3 messages about it.
3 messages. Oh.
That makes me
what the fuck forlorn. Computer is he on? Oh, okay, I see.
Yeah. Forlorn.
That's the power of having two computers. When one was acting up, you go to the other one. That also delayed me a few minutes, too.
Power of...
Yeah, a few minutes. Just a few minutes. You were only late a few minutes, Lou.
Yeah, only a few minutes.
What did he do? Did he just bunny hop? Someone's got to rewind and clip that. I'm pretty sure he just bunny hopped.
Oh, you want a bunny hop? Hold on.
No, thank you.
Bunny hop, bunny hop.
Oh, you're four. Wee,
wee. That's got to be the new morning jam.
You just broke your floor.
Spare us the titties and just give us the bunny hop.
Oh, shit.
Stone's got his fingers. So how'd you like Saw last night? All right, so moving on.
I haven't watched.
All right, so spoil it. Damien, go. This is your chance. This is your chance, Damien. Get him. Get him good. Get him good for all
Everyone's
those times he called
AIDS.
You a drunken piece of shit. Every time he's called you an unemployed Australian kangaroo fucker. Get him right now. Get him.
I don't recall calling him a kangaroo fucker.
Don't be a Toby, Damien. Don't be a Toby. Don't wait. Don't wait. And strike out. What? Don't sit in silence and then strike out in violence. No, no.
Wait, are you gonna do this passive aggressive shit, Jim? You gonna It's a callback.
wait, I'm sorry. Okay, go. Okay. So it's just a joke. I just had to make sure I was going to apologize because, you know, I got to just make sure I'm not hurting people, apparently.
I mean, I'm deeply hurt, but what are you going to do? I mean, I'll cry about it later, but
yeah,
that's no one's business.
Yeah. While you touch yourself.
Oh, all right, as long as you're going to do your crying in private.
You're going to cry in the car.
But you're not going to cry to us about it later, right? Like, if you're going to keep it in private, you're going to keep it in private forever, right? Like a real man, you're just going to just always.
I haven't listened to your video that cleared up audio with Kimmy. What the fuck does it say?
Does it matter? Because you get to hear it in the episode in full, so.
Oh, in today's episode?
Yes.
And I still haven't even watched your one video about the theory, whatever theory they got.
I don't remember, so it doesn't matter. And it was probably wrong.
They were all wrong.
But I think she was dating a retarded guy.
He's fucking her. And he's going, yup.
Miracle Whip is like mayonnaise, right?
Yup.
Yeah.
Yup. And that was, what do you think? Should we, what do you think about this?
Yup.
I think he was mentally challenged.
It's not mayonnaise, but it's close, right? It's kind of close.
No, it isn't.
It's mayo in your a-hole.
What was she eating? A fucking, like a tuna sandwich with Miracle Whip? That makes me sick.
Well, yes, tuna with Miracle Whip does
sound
hideous.
You know what makes me sick, Damien? The fact that you're too much of a pussy to fucking spoil the show.
Oh, he just called you a kangaroo-raping pervert.
Same as every day.
Always with the king.
And he still doesn't. Jesus Christ, you choose violence, yet he just stays quiet. Oh, my Lord.
I get no respect.
You got another Toby. You can just keep walking all over him.
Yep, I can see it. He's going to nuke the channel when he gets steamrolled enough.
You know, just I don't...
Give me a few more days. Let's fucking fuck this channel right in the shitter.
I'm going to say it wasn't just me. Where's this video I'm looking for? It's got to have been all of us. We have all had to have been, even if it was just me. Somebody in this show was very abusive to another member of this show, and they had to sit in silent and suffer the abuse of someone on this show until they finally lashed out. And we can't have that again. So, guys, just chill, all right? Just chill. This is a very sensitive show. We don't do mean stuff here.
It's all about love and tenderness.
Right. We don't abuse one another here. We don't abuse. All right? So
we
somebody
amuse.
Is feeling abused.
We don't abuse, we amuse.
That's right. We're only we're all only here to amuse. We're just having fun. That's all that matters.
That's all that matters.
Jerry Shepardini's.
Girls are just having fun.
Where's Jerry with his announcement?
Yeah, he messaged me again this morning, says he's at the doctor. But,
oh, no!
Unfortunately, he's just being abused by,
Toby.
Toby and Rusty. They've been abusing him for days now, and he's probably just tired of it. He's trying to be strong. He's trying to be strong, but...
Oh, did we talk about Olivia Newton-John passing away at the age of 73?
Who cares?
My sentiments exactly.
Nobody cares about the Olivia Newton-John.
Well, she's famous.
Sandy, oh my God.
I thought she was dead already.
You're dead? Why? She's
already dead.
It's so weird.
Your tits fell off, and then you fell off the planet.
Oh, God,
dude. What are you doing?
That's too much.
It's a bitch too far.
Too much gay.
I think I'm just turning into walking now. Oh.
I got it, Sandy. Your tits. Where'd they go? It's very scary.
Oh, folks.
Tits.
Oh, Lord.
Nope. No tits. And no mayonnaise. I was looking for the mayonnaise video, but it's not offhand. And we're no longer talking about mayonnaise. That was like 10 minutes ago.
Wasn't it 10 minutes ago? I thought
it took you 10 minutes to realize that's gone now.
45 seconds ago. It's not gone. It's somewhere else. I just don't have it offhand. But I hate that moment. Then I get all deflated. When I can't find something I'm looking for, that would be great to play in a moment, and then I have nothing to say for the rest of the show. So,
is that part of your sex life? You get deflated when you can't find it?
Nope.
When you have a hard time finding the hole?
Nope. I find it very easily. It's right where it's supposed to be.
Sure.
It's right there where it's supposed to be. Yep.
Oh yeah.
Where?
In the back of a man.
In a man's butthole.
With a Miracle Whip.
I would put Miracle Whip on a man's butthole.
So, we're 10 episodes away from the magical century mark.
That's when the evil corporate monsters come along. Look, they already sent their evil henchman. Toby.
Hey, you.
Oops, that's not the picture. Whoopsie.
Oh, boy.
That was a video. They sent their evil henchman, Toby, in and had him nuke our channel. That was their first wave in the takeover they're trying to do, these corporate cunts. But we have 10 episodes left.
He finds these pictures, man.
10 episodes left. To I didn't find it. It's what are you talking about? The guy was on 80 something shows. He didn't say much. What are you talking about?
I nuked your channel.
These are all the same picture. We're looking at the same picture. I have 4 copies of the same picture. What a waste. It's like so redundant or whatever you call it. But anyway, The evil corporate people, in 10 episodes we have left now to save this fucking rec center here that is mourning so far. When we get to that momentous episode, Lou, that you mentioned, we're going to have to do some tap dancing and some shucking and jiving.
Yo, did you guys hear about the guy who...
Because they're going to shut us down, perhaps. So... Okay. You know, what do we do? What? What, dickhead? What, dickhead?
The government is such a crook.
Yeah, they're trying to tear down the FGTZ Town Rec Center.
No, they're not.
And people need to save it. We need to fruit boot and rally.
Why does the government need to take $500 million from someone who won? Actually, no. Let me rephrase that. A man won $1.28 billion in the second largest jackpot in Mega Millions history. And the U.S. taxing government took $747.2 million.
You and the woman with this story.
Because bro, it's fucking retarded how the government takes more than
that's
the
what
winner.
They do. That's what they do.
Fucking greedy.
Yeah, no shit. But this guy still got $400 million.
Greedy like this guy on the screen right now.
Cry.
Who misses his beer?
You and the stupid woman want to talk about this stupid guy who's walking away with $400 million. Well, how about everybody else on the fucking planet who the government fucking rapes far fucking worse and can't walk around with $4? Where's the outrage over that? But everybody sees this story. Shut up, bicycle boy Jerry. Fucking Jerry and his bicycle sending me messages.
Can we please
Tee-hee.
Oh my god, it got worse. Oh, I think I'm gonna throw up my coffee now. Yo, where's my Amazon? I'm supposed to be here between 4 and 8. They're running late.
I'm sorry, that's the fucking furthest bridge. I'll never do that again. I'm sorry, that was worse than Jerry when he played that disgusting pterodactyl porn.
Pterodactyl
porn.
Couldn't even do your own joke right.
No.
For shame, Mr. Fancy Penis.
Thank you. But nope, yep, you're right. Nope,
you got a fancy penis? Did you talk about Trump and his Mar-a-Lago estate being raided by the FBI?
Yep. We did. We talked a long time about it, so unfortunately we can't go back over it. That was like the first 40 minutes of the show before you got here. We were so exhausted on that subject. Let's what else we got?
Let me see. A woman is held on $9 million bond after she killed 6 people in a drunken driving.
And Hesh?
She is in extremely critical condition, they say. In a coma now.
What happened? Oh, that's that other lady.
Eh.
I don't remember what she acted in.
Psycho? 7 days and... Oh, yeah, she was in Psycho as well.
Okay, I don't
remember this. Jim, you remember the song on Hollywood Babylon? And Haitia's butthole?
Penis. It's
just
Mr.
a fancy penis.
Penis.
No, I apologize.
I don't. I've always thought Kevin Smith is a blowhard. And he talks too much. And there's just... Come on. Who wants to watch a show where just one guy is just blah, 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 when there's other people there not getting considered and constantly
who would even want to participate in that?
Exactly. It's fucking ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Yeah, so I can't stand... I don't like Kevin Smith as a podcaster.
So...
But it seems I missed something pretty fucking hilarious, huh?
In other news, the Alabama Police Department disbanded...
Wait, before you go on, this... Butthole, Dan Hesh, that's you did just say from a Kevin Smith podcast, right? I didn't say anything.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You just talked about
I think Lou said that.
You just sung a whole song about Dan Hesh's butthole. This is ridiculous. Take it back. Take it back right now.
I don't know what to take back. I'm sorry.
This whole,
God damn it, Lou.
I'm just as dazed and confused as you are.
Job done. All right, next story.
Next story is Alabama City disbands police department over a cop's racist tweet. What do you call a pregnant slave? The message allegedly read. The officer at the center of the racist joke reportedly replied after not getting any satisfying answers. Buy one, get one free.
I want to know what the other answers were that didn't satisfy him.
Now that's funny. Now that's funny.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
That's funny. Well, the two minorities are laughing, and yet the other three white guys are just quiet.
Nice little sidebar. The guy Travis McMichael got life.
Who's he?
For his murder.
Who's he?
Who's
the guy
that?
Who murdered Ahmaud Arbery?
Who they? Oh, Ahmaud Arbery. Yep, don't know him. It's raining.
Of course you don't know him, I guess. I mean, well, I would assume you didn't know him. I don't know him, but he was murdered.
Oh, shit.
Robbery. Well.
While the N-word was used as he was dying.
By the police.
And
No, by the racist suburb watch society. I guess you want to call them that.
Like two,
the father, and son chasing a jogger down the street with the other guy in his camera. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, basically. Those idiots.
Yeah, those idiots.
Okay, well, that sounds horrible.
Yeah, it was horrible. Very horrible.
Oh man.
Yeah, there's so many horrible videos on the internet these days. So many. There was a show that would showcase some of these horrible videos called Crime Report before Pat Dixon, the fucking pervert loser, sucker punched Gino. But the problem was they were only focusing on all of the black hate crimes against white people and Asians and stuff like that. And, you know, it would be nice if they would have peppered in the rare of these horrendous racial things so that they could have presented, you know, an accurate view of things.
But, you know, that
see how convoluted and double-sided that whole thing I just said was? Did you get it all, everybody?
Got it in.
It's like a porcupine, that one.
Like got it in.
Everywhere. Pricks in all directions. Go on. You were going to say?
No, I'm just jiving. Like I said, I don't know. It didn't jive with, you know, with the overall mentality and viewpoint, which is why his punch to Gino was just so jarring to everyone, because it just completely shattered the mental view.
Mr. A Crab's mental view is shattered. He has not moved from that position. he's just been sitting there with some glasses on his face, just waiting.
Got some good weed.
When would they notice that I am dead?
Got some good weed.
Got some good weed.
Ding. Oh, you're back. Guess who's
whenever
back?
Whenever you hear that bell, everyone, that's Jim me. Is back. I'm the bell person, everyone.
Jim is back.
See, I did it.
I'm gonna pass.
Did it again.
Jim is back. Jim
is back. Broke. You punched it. You can't punch it.
I hit my bell too hard. My bell that I have here. Hit it too hard. What is that?
Who's pissing?
It's his turtle tank.
Oh, that's what that is. It sounds like a trouble. It sounds nice. It's very nice. I like it.
It's very soothing.
But it's the exact sound I have coming from outside as well. It's a fucking tsunami out there.
That's someone pissing on your window.
What, you got rain coming?
It's a heavy but gentle rain. Very calm and still, but it's coming down hard.
Gentle rain.
Fall in on my face again.
Gentle rain. So, Jim, are you going to work today? Did you announce that at the beginning of the show? You know,
I
was
not
40 announce, minutes late.
I did not announce any sort of such thing.
We're going to go for 4 hours today. Yeah.
I don't know anything about... didn't say anything about that.
You didn't got nothing better to do, you know. Damien has no life. Brett, Mr. Krat. Mr. A Crab now, instead of A Rab, he's A Crab. Has no life. I can't speak for Stone Dage.
I have many lives.
He wears many hats. Most on his Jimmy.
Oh God! Buy one get one free. That brought a chuckle to me.
Man, wow.
I didn't find that humorous. I think it's just only because it's just what I expect.
Oh, funny, what made it racist? Me, the fucking part that he said slave?
No, buy one, get one free. It's not racist. It's a.
I could have walked into my local public offensive. It's, and I got one free.
I think we need a society to separate. I can't say words today. I got us. We need to separate what is racist and what is offensive. Offensive isn't always fucking racist, and that's the thing about that joke. I expect that joke. It's a simple, typical, offensive joke. If there was some sort of subversion to the norm in that joke, you might get a laugh out of me. That's what I like. Things that are offensive, But also, they trick me. If you manage to trick me, that's what makes me give you the very fake thing called a laugh. Laughs aren't real. We're not fucking stupid, dumb monkeys still. Okay? I know it's a part of our old thing.
You think to yourself, but my laugh was real. That's what made me laugh.
I liken some people's laugh to the hyena. I think some, you know, I liken theirs to the hyena.
Fine. You know, all animals, different animals. So, whatever. But, hey, listen. Let's even talk about, let's say, go into the monkey thing, and that there are different animals, like hyenas. You know, so maybe it is different. All the different races are like different animals, not just different kinds of monkeys. So let's say even that were the case, and we're not all monkeys. Then wouldn't calling black people monkeys be a good thing? Because monkeys are pretty much the smartest of the goddamn fucking animal world. You know what I'm saying? They might not be the most powerful. They may get eaten by a lion. But, you know, they'll also be able to... Well, they'll really think about that death, as opposed... They got the thumbs, man! The monkeys got the thumbs! I think the monkeys win, as far as the animal world goes. They'd have the best chance at a Planet of the Apes situation. So there's... What I'm simply trying to say is there's no way that calling the black a monkey should be considered offensive at all. Or racist.
Jim, I had a job. I had a job, and there was a black person, and he was pretending to be a monkey to be funny, but I didn't want to laugh because, you know... They could be right.
Because laughter's fake.
Racist. Yeah, it's fake.
Which is why you didn't offer it, because you choose when to laugh and when not to laugh. Even sometimes you have your little monkey or hyena instinct to go... It's there, but your brain chooses when to give or not to give that thing.
But as I've gotten older, I always felt like that the whole monkey thing was just what was a big part of, like,
it's retarded.
Go ahead. It's like the overall, like, mainstream, like, typical white society trying to distance themselves from evolution and clinging more to creationism, first of all, and then to make when they're calling someone a monkey, it's more to the when a typical racist white person calls a black person a monkey, it's playing more to the typical dancing, scratching, shit throwing aspect of a monkey, not the intelligent, you know, whenever someone makes a monkey reference, I like to always say, you know, we believe in evolution, because I know what they're thinking when they call us a monkey. It's about all of this shit. That's the thing. The bananas were dancing on a string while the guy, you know what I'm saying, while the guy plays the accordion, and that's what they're thinking about. You know, see, that's what they're thinking about. So I just always like the flipping and reversing on them. And you watch enough Nat Geo and Discovery Channel, like when I did, I was a kid coming up.
You know
up.
What that dancing monkey also does? It steals your wallet. So maybe that's, he plays the thing, and the monkey does a little dance. He goes around and steals people's wallets. You know.
But
that?
You know who? But you know. But you know what's funny? You know who teaches him? You know who teaches those monkeys to do that? You know what I'm saying? Other races.
Yeah. The owner.
But you know, I was holding back a much better joke, Mr. A Crab, to give you an example of just a higher level of I was just gonna say that I forgot, like always. I was gonna say that we heard Mr. Stone's evolution. We know what you like to say when you said you like to say this, and I was gonna say we have 90 episodes to prove it, but we don't. Some stupid N-word nuked our channel.
Out of curiosity,
but I was gonna say the word if the timing was right. You see, and that's another thing to Gino Bisconte. Excuse me, Lou. I have to address Gino Bisconte.
Go ahead, Steve
Conti's a coward because he won't say N-word fully out, like the full word. And Steve Conte's like, I'll say that when I want to say it. And he says it when he wanted to say it in a proper context. There really is that there's the timing makes a goddamn fucking difference. You don't just say it, and that's the point. that's where he is falling down N-word Mountain. He's choosing to fight his little war on N-word Mountain, but he's failing in that regard. It's not a word that you just say in any single instant. You can, but there are repercussions in the social context. If you're sitting in your closet alone going, nothing's going to happen. You can say it. You can say it.
You might be psychotic, though.
Probably. No, but, well, that's exactly it. You can say it. Nothing's going to happen. But somebody opens that closet door, you might get taken. You might get taken to the nut house if it's like your partner or
possibly that demon from, what was it? What was the fucking movie? Possibly that little demon from fucking, what are those fucking movies that I'm forgetting right now?
I don't know, but the point, just to end it and then go back, think about it while I say this. The fucking point literally is you can say it whenever, but there are times that when you say it, it is bad. It can do bad things to your cause. It could get you punched in the face. It could get you institutionalized because you were standing alone, masturbating in a closet, saying that word.
Jerking turkey.
Just saying.
Just jerking.
That's all. That is all. N-word.
When you're jerking your cock now. Oh, what was I going to say? Oh, did you save the Lou show?
Yeah, they're all on this channel. Yep, and no, there was only one that was on that other channel, and I did save that as well.
Well, see, Damien, we've been saved, so maybe now we can make a triumphant return since you're the new Toby.
Oh, boy. Well, if it means he's sitting there seeming to have a good time, laughing a lot, smiling mostly, and then one day is just going to lash out violently and attack us all in a fit of rage and psychosis, then yes, he is the new Toby.
There's no fun in that. He's the new Toby as far as being my, like, second chair. No, third chair. Mr. A. Crab could be fourth chair where you're there if you want to be.
That's so sweet. It's like the sweetest. I'm like, this is so sweet. I want to cry now. A heartwarming show.
A Crab has grown on me.
Love and tenderness is what I'm saying.
Damon, El Camino is fabulous. Oh my god, El Camino is a dog shit movie. It's not fabulous.
Somebody else wanted nostalgia. Someone wanted nostalgia. Isn't that right, Lou? You wanted nostalgia on that movie, huh?
No. It needed to just do simple things, and it didn't do it. So that show could go kick donkey dick.
Simple things. I like what?
All it had to do, because it's taking place right after fucking Walter gave Styler the coordinates to where Hank and Gomes were buried. Take 1 minute while you're doing that news broadcast that said Walter White is dead to also include that, and you close that chapter of the show's story too. Then the movie could have been a little better, but it didn't do it. The movie was fucking boring. And like Jim says, you got a fat Jesse Plemons. I understand he was probably fat for another role, but Jesus Christ. No. Get him in shape, goddammit. He kind of takes you out the fucking thing when you're doing the flashbacks with him.
He didn't get fat for a role. He's fat because he's fat.
Yeah, he took that Breaking Bad money and just fucking enjoyed life. A bit too much, I guess.
He didn't seem fat to me in Central Intelligence.
Yeah, I don't think he was fat in that one.
Okay, now you said Jesse Plemons, right?
He did.
So he was a big fat piggy. He was a big fat piggy. It was horrible, those scenes with him in it.
This can't be the same guy. Hold on, because
he is jiggling. He fucking buries his face in Kirsten Dunst's big fucking tits and goes.
Yeah, it's him. The mind boggler. I figured you were talking about that guy. The mind boggler. It boggles. No, you know what? It doesn't boggle my mind anymore because
you realize that Kirsten Dunst is clearly a pedophile. No, I wondered because I was like, how? Like, the only thing he did was play that little boy on Breaking Bad, and next thing you know, he's dick deep in Hollywood royalty vagina. But I found out when they got together was on the set of Fargo, and if you look at him on Fargo, he is already a wrecked man. He's already a big fat blob of a fucking goblin.
See, let me address something real quick. Hold on.
Go ahead.
Yes, Michael B., I take up three chairs because that's a nice fat joke. Ha, ha, ha.
Oh, I get it. He's first, second, and third chair. Well, that makes sense in multiple levels.
But I would just say it used to boggle my mind at first. I used to be just confounded. Like, what the fuck? Like, they're, what? Okay, but you know what? I was like, you know what? It happens to a lot of females, regardless of their race or whatever. Females, when they're younger, they'll go and they'll date
bitches,
all the
face. Right?
They'll date all the face men. They'll date all the fuck boys. They'll, you know what I'm saying? They'll date all the guys that'll make other girls envious.
But they still won't date the Tobies of this world.
I don't know. See, Jesse Plemons may be the fucking Toby. After, you know what I'm saying? After all that time, when they're finally ready to settle down, they fucking select a Toby.
Toby could not even get his fucking pencil penis into the giant cavern that is KB's undesirable vagina.
You're just gonna sit back and just toss it in. How hard?
Oh, yeah, that's all you gotta do. He couldn't even. I'm so. She's being such a good sport on the jokes, but boy, they've got to. Eventually, there must be a limit. He can't even get it into that. KB's the kind of girl who the only time she gets sex is after a visit to the produce department. Am I right? Cucumbers.
Well, how do we get so fucking far off track? Obsessed?
I don't know, but it's about timing what I was saying before. And I got to reiterate the point because, listen, when I'm making these jokes, I'm not making it for a racist audience. Let that be clear, because then I would just say it at any time. If I were to have interrupted you when I did, and if I would have made that joke about Toby being an N-word and said the word, depending on my timing, it would have either made you crack up fucking laughing or give me, because remember, laughter is all fake and it's all a little, it's payment that we give each other. Or you'd give me a chuckle or you'd give me some sort of visible acknowledgement that, you know, you get the joke. Eh, it wasn't that funny, but hey, whatever. Or you would go, you motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? It's all dependent upon that timing. So, anyway, Pixel says, how does this show get off track? H, what are you, retarded? Fucking Pixel, that is rude. Oh, look at him. He looks like a little hipster in that picture. You look like you're going to program someone's computer or something. You look like you're the IT guy that's going to find the child porn on Toby's computer. Now, listen, I've made it very clear that there is no way in hell that Jerry Shepardini of Scotland notifies Scotland Yard immediately.
It's not in Scotland.
That's enough. That's enough. Look, we made it clear that that's not the case with Jerry. I've never once said that or stated that. But it's okay, right, to make jokes that Pixel looks like the guy who's going to find the child porn on Toby's computer after Toby nuked her. Again, if Gino were to say jokes about Pat Dixon being a pedophile, those would be acceptable right now, right? Because his jaw was broke. So I'm just saying, what is the border? What is the line? Pixel, you look so handsome in that picture. Anyway.
Carry on.
Yeah, Stone, so how do you get off track so bad, like Pixel said?
No. Off that conversation, I mean, we were talking about Jesse Plemons and Kirsten, you know, and you
motorboat those titties.
Look, bro, she had enough of Toby Maguire and his broken back, couldn't fuck her right, so she went to Jesse Plemons and
it wasn't that easy. Come on, you. Oh yeah, it was.
Think he motorboats her butthole too?
No, please,
her butt cheeks against.
She was probably more discreet, but
too, because they're like it's too. just meat patties.
But she went through her share of guys that would make other girls envious and the fuck boys, and then all of a sudden it was like, yeah, this guy, this is the guy that should be my husband. Oh, he'll worship me. You know what I'm saying? He'll fucking worship me.
That's a plausible, but look, okay, well, I guess in Hollywood, you know what? You might be right, because boil it down. In Hollywood, she might not be that attractive. In the real world, people may look at her as like this mystical beast, like a unicorn you could fuck. Another kind. You could fuck unicorns, I'm sure.
A unicorn.
If you could find one.
Yeah, you might be right, because in Hollywood, she may not be as attractive to that world, but she wants somebody on her level, which means, you know, an actor who's not just like, whatever. I guess that guy did pick up enough steam. Maybe it is. She wants to be worshipped by somebody lesser, but close to.
I mean, let's be real. How long did it take you to find your significant other?
Fucking Damien, calm down.
How long
down.
Did it take you to, you know, knock down your trail of women before you finally found the right one?
He had sex with two women.
I mean, it was sort of a different thing with me, though, because
I think it's passive aggressive that he's not asking Damien.
Wow, really?
Damien single,
is it? Or Mr. A?
Damien has said single. Either of them. That could be the same question for Mr. A. Crab.
We'll
and the same
them.
Question for
we'll
you,
get to
fancy
them.
Dick.
We'll get to them. I would like to count. Let's get to it. Go ahead,
Jesus
Mr. Stone.
Christ.
You're first. How many sexes did you have?
But see, it wasn't because see to count sexual partners, it wouldn't be the same for me because there was a
putting
point where
putting
it
in I, their vagina.
No, well, no,
it's not about
it wasn't
partners.
Yeah,
I'm sure you dated, because you've probably had a couple of one-night stands where it's just quick nut and done. We're not talking about those. We're talking about, like, a girl people, you dated maybe for a year, and you figured, well, this isn't working out. Well,
that's stupid.
It was only a few that I was seriously, when I was seriously in that mode of looking for a relationship, it was only a few that I, you know what I'm saying, that didn't work out before I found,
your
you
one.
Know, the one, yeah. It wasn't... Because it's just like, because you know, because once, I think most people know, men and women, I think, especially women, they know, they're fucking somebody, they're with somebody that they're just with for a certain purpose. They're not thinking that they're going to marry this guy. They're, you know, it's about, either it's about clout, either it's about, I always wanted the fuck that guy, or whatever, and they're just doing that. And then when they just, and then you get into that mode of, okay, I'm ready for a relationship, this is what I need. I don't necessarily need a fucking face man or a guy with a, you know what I'm saying, with a svelte body. I need, you know, I need somebody who's going to be there for me, and we can have those nice little podunk moments at home and be corny, and Jesse, that's the guy, you know what I'm saying, and you know what I'm saying, and it's just like, you know, he'll worship me, and he'll do the fuck I want, and he'll never, he'd probably go to a fucking nudist colony, you know what I'm saying, full of prostitutes, and wouldn't cheat on me, you know what I'm saying? I mean, that's what she's thinking in her fucking head.
He'll never tell me my cooter smells. He's a good guy.
I could go out and fuck, you know what I'm saying, all the guys in my next movie, and he'll be waiting back for me at home with flowers.
Well, I don't know about that.
He probably would. He looks like the type.
I'm being over the top just to kind of bring a little lightness to the situation. But overall, I'm just saying, like, sometimes at a certain point when women finally decide they're ready to settle down, they're not looking at the, oh my God, he looks good. Oh my God, he has this sweat. Oh my God, he has this. You're looking for the guy who's going to be.
But you think about it. I feel most people in Hollywood that are actors and actresses date each other for clout to help boost their careers.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
Because 9 times out of 10, the majority of them don't marry each other. Some do. Some don't.
Well, you know, they get all forlornly and they have to...
What? What
Damien?
Was that?
Damien. Hmm? Do you know karate?
Do what?
Do yes. you know karate?
He knows karate.
Karate?
Dude, that's coming back soon. One month ago, Jim. And then you could be watching Flick Tour for the Karate Cobra Kai.
Yeah.
Cobra Kai.
Oh, here comes a crab. Oh, you guys watch that? That's a pedophile show. It's got kids.
Karate is for pedos.
Yeah. You know, tell him Steve Dave did a whole conversation about Stranger Things. Now listen, Brian Johnson, that one's a hard pickle to swallow when it comes to defending him. Where did Damien go? Talks finally get into his fucking wheelhouse. Segway.
Nope.
Fucking right off a fucking... What, how am I down to one cigarette? I had four when this stupid thing started. It's time to...
Okay. You smoke too much.
But please go ahead because, you know...
I don't know. They were he's gone now and it's pointless now.
No, I'm still invested because, you know... I'm not big enough. Stranger Things fan.
Yeah, but I don't want to have to talk about it again later. We'll get back to it. How about that? So, Wait. Before you get to that, speaking of kids things, movies with kids in them, has anyone seen Psycho Goreman?
No.
I think I
watched most of that last night.
Bro,
again.
You watched the weirdest fucking shit.
It's a fucking great movie. I watched most
of it. Oh, just like you said, I started it. It's pretty good. This movie.
It was good. It started good, and then it was garbage. That's how a lot of movies go. They start good, and then they turn to garbage.
Yeah.
Fucking they and them was garbage.
They slash them. The title is great.
I would not watch any fucking movie with pronouns in it.
Okay. Well, you're a racist. What do you want from me?
Fucking they, them. I got a they.
You hate queers. That's your business. All right, fine. Pixel says. This is the ADD show.
People know they find or fund the right partner. Then 5 to 10 years, it's a divorce. Divorce rates are up 80% according to a recent statistic in the U.S. of 2017. That Canada divorce, 60%, is high of by 2022. We're not in Canada, so we don't.
I don't know what I don't know what was worse, the comment or the reading of the comment.
Your face was worse.
I don't know which I care about less.
Both.
I'm just kidding. It was lovely. They Live was a great movie. Best fight scene ever. Yeah.
One's talking about They Live.
But we just did. Nope. We just did. He's like they slash them, and he's jumping from They Live. I think he's following the same fucking field. That's exactly what we're doing on this show. I don't have the energy to go crazy today, I think is what it is, and it's all just mishmashed and forced for me.
If you're fucking your energy depletion is too low, then don't just take back and recharge. Smoke a bowl.
Yeah, I think I've been doing that this whole time.
Smoke a bowl.
Reason why I haven't come on to camera.
Smoke a bowl. And smoke
a bowl. I'm gonna go shave.
You want to shave your butthole?
No, not my butthole. I'm thinking I'm gonna get rid of all the cheek. And just do like a real rapper beard.
The fuck is a rapper beard?
My normal kind of beard, but I'm always accused of having an ethnic beard, so I roll with.
Bro, who the fuck accuses you of having an ethnic beard? Like people, you live, people, your people must not really see a bunch of ethnic people.
Indians in stores. All right, let's just start there. Not one convenience store, multiple convenience stores will call me Osama or DJ Khalid, depending on the beard. Okay? That's a regular. For years, it would go on like that.
The fact is, you look like neither.
No, it looks like Osama.
People I've known in my personal life, people I've known online, it'll be like
Fidel Castro. You got a turban? Put on a turban.
Or
I can see Fidel Castro.
It all depends on my beard, but it's always someone ethnic. And yeah, so I'm going to give myself a nice little rapper beard.
I could see the Fidel, maybe, but not Khaled. I'd have to see you in a turban.
And who else takes the cheeks all the way down, but then leaves all this mess? But rappers and the blacks and white rappers. That's who do that.
I thought you wanted a chin strap beard. Just a little line. Are you going to do that?
Well, it's basically the chin strap, but with all the neck beard left. Like, you keep all this under stuff.
No, that's not
so. This that sounds appalling. Here, and yeah, all of this, and we're going to see. Because then what I'll be left with is a fucking goatee like a real queer.
That's I'd rather you just have like a tiny mustache. Ready to
suck
you are a real like queer now. Wearing a
like how Damien looked when he after he shaved and then he had a goatee. Oh no, you had the goatee. How Damien used to look regularly with that goatee, like he was ready to line up at bathroom stalls and suck them all.
I never saw that.
Instead of going back to that,
Pixel, so
they just don't want me no more.
I don't care about They Live. I never saw it.
Well, then good point there, Pixel. It's a very good point.
It's not a good point because I never saw the movie, so I still...
But it's still a pronoun movie. It doesn't change the fact that it's still a pronoun movie.
But
you're correct, Lou. You're correct. I can't believe we're battling you two fucking jerks right now with your gibberish.
They Live.
You're forlornly.
They Live.
You missed
the...
You've never heard of They Live?
What? I might have. I just don't remember what it was.
It's with Rowdy Rowdy Piper.
Oh, that's one of the most memed movies ever.
Yeah, I never saw this movie.
It was a nice one.
Fantastic.
Yeah, he wears these sunglasses and he can see aliens.
It's Rapey Roddy Piper.
I mean, if you'd seen that movie, perhaps things would be
very rowdy.
And
oh, look, Jim is sharing. Ooh, the show
wouldn't be so brainwashed by the far left.
Oh, yeah, go ahead. Look at those milky titties.
It's a really good movie. I enjoy it a whole lot.
Oh yeah, I'm touching myself for you, Jim.
Wait, am I a great big fat person?
Jim has a weird hair structure on his chest. He's over here posing like Buffalo Bill now.
Tuck it in.
Damien, Damien. Oh, pinch him, baby, pinch him.
Goodbye, horses.
Too bad the bitch ain't around to see him doing that crazy shit.
Mm-hmm. She'd be over there going, punching her cunt. She'd be getting so aroused, gushing. Going
and just,
nuts.
And then splash you right there. Slip and slide.
That's vulgar.
Slip and slide. Where did I put it? There it went.
Oh.
Wait a minute. Get that back on. Get that back on. Play it some more.
You're
going
to get booted for it.
Oh, don't do it then. Never mind. I was going to... I could have made the singing over. Somebody sing.
You told me.
Damn, yeah, there you go. Sing it. No. I don't want to do this anymore. I don't want to do it anymore.
Do you think that band was pissed that song is just... Like, it's just that now?
It's the only way it's known.
Hold on, son. I think you're wrong. I must disagree. Hold on, son. Yeah? Okay. I can put it back on. Why don't you listen to me?
Okay. I know the chorus. Knowing the verses is disturbing.
He told me I've seen it all before. My hopes and dreams are lying on the ground. Okay, I'm not doing it.
Hey, Crab, why don't you go and petition to join Lucas's band?
Because he lives 500 miles away from me.
So I think he'd be an actual good member. You might be able to pull off a couple of rock songs. God, I hate my life. Well, your life hates you, Michael Bay.
That'd be nice. I'd like to try that, but I hadn't practiced.
Where'd Jim go?
He left because I was singing. He doesn't like it.
He touched himself too much. Now he has to go fucking jerk off to himself in the mirror.
Anytime he hears "Goodbye Horses," he's got to go.
Why does Michael? I'm just curious to know, what did Mr. A Crab and myself do to Michael B that he hates us so much?
We were born.
God damn it! That's what I was coming to say.
I'm sure you can get a list if you really want it.
What's that?
I said, I'm sure you can get a list if you really want it.
Well, I just got a compliment. I got a good comeback, Lou. Oh, I feel so special now.
I'm fairly sure that's sarcastic.
I'm pretty sure it is too, but it still made me feel special.
I'm a special. And that is what is important. It's all about how one receives.
Oh, I never said I hated either of you.
That is true. Michael said he just never wants to see or hear you. He will pay you money.
Yeah, he just says you guys are retarded. That's all.
Yeah. That's offensive, fine. Jim. That word is very offensive.
No, it's back on the rise. It's back on the rise. People are saying it all over. They were just talking about it on this week's Tell 'Em Steve Dave, which is a great segue back into it. They were talking about how Brian Quinn was saying, everyone's saying retarded. He's hearing it more than he's ever heard it in all types of mainstream and regular things. Even I was hearing it on, I think it was like Sal Volcano's podcast. One of his guests was saying retarded a bunch.
And it's that guest was somebody famous. You can't say spaz anymore.
Well, that's funny. So did you listen to the episode, that means?
No, not yet.
That's literally what they said.
Not really?
And then they go on a whole, they start ranting on about spaz on that ass. And they're like, well, that would be.
Was that the Beyonce one? The most recent thing?
Oh, that's why. Yep.
Because Lizzo had to take it out of a song, and so did Beyonce.
Well, they mentioned both of those clowns. They mentioned Lizzo and that, but they also talked about Stranger Things for a good while. And if I had more foresight, and I would have
foreskin.
I was trying to think of some way to tie forlornly into that, but I couldn't. If I was more forlornly, I would have brought a clip to play.
Forlornly,
or if we had a clip person, yeah, I think that's the word. I'm not completely sure. But they were talking about Stranger Things, and not in any way, shape, or form did it seem like any of them wanted to fuck those children. Not at any point were they like, oh, did you see that one kid's ass? I love the way those cheeks were jiggling. None of that stuff was being
said. Wait, so should I skip the newest episode until I've seen some, or... Like
No. They don't. They're. It's a mostly spoiler free episode. I mean discussion. But they do talk a little bit about season four, which I'll just say, which what?
And touching kids.
Well, that's the thing. They would talk about that a lot, but it was had nothing to do with Stranger Things. They just kept randomly talking about wanting to bang those kids. And about how some fucking guy named Toby just kept coming around and banging kids on their doorstep. It was weird.
Banging.
In the middle of the night, someone would ring their bell, they'd open it up, and it was some weasel-looking creep banging a kid on their doorstep. Yeah, they would shoot the shotgun in the air, and it would scurry off with the kid in its mouth. It was weird.
So Kim's life has become...
disturbing shit.
So Kim has suffered a fate even worse than death. She's boring and stuck in Florida.
Yep.
In the intro to that episode, I thought maybe she'd had some kind of brain injury, too.
Yep.
Like, her boyfriend is fucking... dumb as shit.
Yep.
And she was just. Yep. She seemed to be about the same.
Yep. I have vowed to the woman that the next time I grace her with the pleasure and glory of my fancy penis, I will do that. I have forsworn it.
You're gonna do what? Put Miracle Whip on it?
Yep.
Take this miracle dick.
Yep.
Engage.
Yep. 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 Yep.
Yep.
Yep.
It's like, is that not one of the most disturbing scenes in anything you've seen in recent times?
Yep. No, I masturbated to it.
I'm sure you did, but
oh my lord! So disturbing? There really is a Miracle Whip scene.
Yes, she eats tuna with Miracle Whip like a fucking weirdo.
No, it's not tuna; it's potato salad.
No,
it's both.
It's both.
Oh, my girlfriend eats tuna with Miracle Whip.
Your girlfriend's a sinner.
The boyfriend comes home.
Dirty, 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 dirty sinner.
Dirty girl. My dad, the boyfriend comes home.
My dad couldn't makes get mayonnaise. Tuna fish, macaroni, and Miracle Whip.
Yeah, that's fine. That's delicious. Well,
okay. I'm well, still. Listen. I don't know if I'm more or less sickened by that. I think slightly less.
No,
at least there's a
does it put onions in it? Actually, I don't know if that would make it worse.
Yeah,
I don't want to read no more. I want to actually enjoy this episode.
Macaroni cooked with tuna fish with I don't know if it. I can't remember if it was. Miracle Whip or just mayonnaise? Probably just mayonnaise because I don't like Miracle Whip.
Then it's like, delicious. If it's just mayonnaise, it's delicious.
Miracle Whip's the one that's essentially just sugar, right?
I have no idea, but it's also delicious. Try yourself, folks. Folks, if you don't like Miracle Whip out there, get yourself a fucking steaming, juicy hunk of brisket and throw it on a fucking roll. And glob some Miracle Whip on that bitch. You'll shut your fucking mouth. Guaranteed.
Kind of weird, just a weird tinge to it. I don't like it. It's not just regular mayonnaise is fine.
So in other news, I watched Justice League last night. 4-hour masterpiece.
Well, we're trying...
The new version?
Wait, hold on, Damien, Lou. We're trying to talk about things that you don't masturbate to. That each, okay. You know.
Put
so
that back up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. Go on. You were saying now. Sorry.
Just gonna leave that up there. Continue.
The list of what you guys don't masturbate to would be shorter.
Don't worry about that. Justice
League. Justice League is off. No, Justice League's off the table because clearly he masturbates to superhero shows and stuff.
Yes.
No. I'm just trying to say Lou's gay. Jeez.
Oh. Super tight butt cheeks.
Mr. A, are you a Superman fan by chance? Do you like this?
Yeah, of course. I'm a big... What the dude?
Michael B., you're an idiot. Shut your mouth.
Shut your mouth.
Shut your damn dirty stupid mouth.
Miracle Whip on brisket is one of the signs of the apocalypse.
I'm not saying... I hope you didn't fucking hear me say put a fucking brisket on a plate and then daub, glob, Miracle... You have a fucking Kaiser roll, clown. Kaiser roll, goddammit. Kaiser roll, brisket, Miracle Whip. Do it. And then say
Kaiser
something.
Kaiser roll,
you're
brisket,
an abomination.
Miracle Whip, eat it.
Do it. And then talk your shit. Talk that shit.
If Miracle Whip is what I'm thinking of, it is delicious, but on top of any kind of meat just seems wrong.
What would you put it on? Peanut butter?
Not meat.
No, are you thinking of fluff? Are you thinking of like the marshmallow fluff?
Maybe I am.
Because that is not Miracle Whip. Those are
what's Miracle Whip then?
Condiments.
Yeah, Miracle Whip is like mayonnaise, but with a weird spice to it.
It's a tangy mayonnaise. It's a salad dressing.
Tangy mayonnaise,
Yeah, I think I was thinking
not peanut butter fluff.
Because I was like, who the fuck would... Okay.
It's almost like
makes a lot more sense.
It's almost like a mix of relish and mayonnaise without any chunks, or it's just white, but it's like got like the tanginess of like a relish mixed with mayonnaise.
Mom,
still sounds
kind of
weird, but it could be good.
You make me a peanut butter and Miracle Whip sandwich, please. Thank you.
Okay.
I was thinking,
Mom sounds hot.
I think I was thinking of fucking marshmallow fluff. It's like, what kind of fucking sick piece of garbage has that with tuna? Or in a potato salad? You should be shot.
I like that last comment. Whoa.
This one's throwing down. I can take Lou, I can take Bradley, anally. I will not abide Miracle Whip on brisket. Well, you know what you might abide then, Michael B. Another episode of Mr. Fancy Penis, I don't want to do it.
No.
The worm and the crab. And
the gay guy, the worm, the crab, with and the word. I thought he was a
Mr.
horse.
Salty balls.
He's not here. We can call him anything we want.
Balls and salt.
We can call him salted chocolate milk, which he really, really hates. Miracle Whip is sweeter than regular mayo. Yeah, duh, Michael. Everything everybody said was, except for Damien, who's an idiot and thought it was peanut fluff. Goddamn fluff. Yeah, go put some marshmallow on your brisket. Of course, I'd be insane.
That's what I thought. Like, just go ahead and fucking hang
yourself.
You really
are, Toby. You just were sitting there not even addressing how insane it is. You're just like, oh, I'm going to accept it, even though that's completely insane.
You got chocolate in my Miracle Whip. Oh, you got Miracle Whip on my chocolate.
Now I feel sick again.
So how was free beer and hot wings today?
I just was telling that stupid woman how sad I am in this new car that I don't get to hear it. I think I said it on the show, too, to these stupid women. Ba-bum.
Yeah, you've told stupid Damien a few times.
I don't get to listen anymore, and it makes me very... Oh, yeah, we did, because then Mr. Ace Crab said, look, I'll put it on my radio.
Yeah.
We had
I get
bit.
Free
you
beer and
it.
Hot
That's
wings
what you
all
get being
time.
40 minutes late. So have we appeased the Looster enough? Is it stale chip time?
You want stale chips? Stale chips. Stale chips and dip.
Well, I don't even know.
I think we reached stale chip about 5 minutes in.
Oh.
Every day.
I'm crazy for Miracle Whip on a brisket sandwich, but this goblin Miracle Whip and banana sandwich, and that doesn't sound crazy. I know you're not. He's not even saying that they're gonna eat it. Just simply not calling that crazy. You're crazy.
You're crazy.
I'm outraged by this entire conversation. I'm outraged by this show. Oh, damn it. You know, we didn't do the voices, but pretty much that was salted chocolate milk. That's pretty much what we just did.
That's pretty much the show.
Yeah.
What? We're over? No.
That's the Miracle Whip. I'm Hot Wings.
I'm not
free beer. I think the opposite of whatever you said.
I hit that bell.
I got it.
All right. So since nobody is saying anything anymore, it's time to
take a shit. I'll be back.
Yep, exactly. You be back, and we will be here when you return. Go take a shit, and we will be here.
You guys get to hear the massive load. Drop into the toilet bowl.
So go ahead.
Like
who's going to shit
out
now?
A can of tomatoes.
I thought I had to shit when I got up, but it went away.
Ah.
What should I do today, guys? What should I do today on my spectacular days of days? I'm not saying what it is.
After you take a shit, because that obviously first you do that, you should certainly stop at your local rest stop. And patronize the fine folk there, because that is a sacred American industry that must be supported in these trying times. I'm sorry to get heavy on you guys, but we got to take the moment to address these things if the moment arises.
Oh, fuck. Oh, it arised. It has arised.
Oh, it'll arise when you get there. That's for sure. And then you'll fuck some guys.
Oh, that felt good.
He said that man's penis felt good inside of his asshole.
Oh. Lou's at a rest stop right now. Sounds.
Oh, is he at the toilet? Did he go to the toilet already?
He's taking his shit and also getting it pushed back in at the same time.
Q4 has been officially canceled by Netflix after one season.
He's tapping his foot on the ground and looking around.
I'm taking way too long with this right now.
Faggot Town, Morning So Far, featuring steam-powered man Damien Rogers. And Mainframe Multimedia One is live.
What you forgot Mr. A-Crab and his quote-unquote real name, but not his real name because we don't say that here.
There you go. That's why I didn't mention it.
And not Lou, because Lou wants nothing to do with it.
I don't want to reveal his name and be considered a doctor. These chips got into are like one time thirsty. For that, and that shit was hilarious.
Are you really shitting?
Yes, I am. I'm on the toilet.
Okay, I just had to clarify. Now, listen, everybody, we're just going to sit quietly while Lou shits, and we will continue the show 100% as soon as he's done shitting. The show is not ending right now. I feel everything I say must be made very clear these days. You never know. You never know.
You never know when you're gonna relax and shit so well. Shit so swell.
That's terrible. I'm sorry. That's terrible. I'm sorry. That's terrible. I'm sorry. That's terrible.
What the fuck? Taking the shit in all the toilet bowls. Taking the shit.
Question like hey. Yeah! Pushing my shit out like,
Bet I got stripes like a tiger, zebra. Cloud nine life, sky high up the reefer. Got a new bitch that be all up in the photographs in a faux shit, but she know Mona Lisa. Got a new whip that I'm running gas, so the only fuel that I need for my lungs is the diesel. Keep it fucking playing like a running back, running back.
Truly one of the most horrifying gifts that's ever existed.
All right, you back from pooping now?
No.
All right, we can